Welcome back to TYT Sports. We have your last clip in your feel good story.
Like the microphone just blew up. When
you might have.
Bart was in there. And he just dropped one. He's like, Bart, oh Jesus!
Bart was like, oh,
we got a Bart. We got a.
Do that one time. Do that one more time.
Yesterday it started to trend, and Ball's Life was, I think, the first to pick it up, and then of course SportsCenter and the likes that get shared. Here is a 13-year-old who has no arms but prosthetic arms, and gets buckets.
Beautiful.
Sean Marion had that same style. And this kid with no arms does it better than Sean Marion does.
But the video is great.
No, it is. The video is amazing.
What Joey was saying, beautiful. That's awesome. I'm glad for this kid. But I'm gonna be the asshole here. Who's gonna D up the kid with no arms? Not the first guy.
I would.
That guy. The other guy was like, I'll try to put a hand.
LeVar Ball would.
Like, no one's gonna be that guy.
LeVar Ball would.
He would. He'd be like, just I could beat that kid one on one.
LeVar Ball.
He would need help.
LeVar Ball would D him up.
No doubt.
It's actually, it's like when we had in college at Rhode Island, they had, we used to do co-ed basketball tournaments in Greek life. They do it across like the whole campus. And it was always the problem is if you got assigned a girl that you had to D up and she beat you, your friends were going to make fun of you forever. But if you crossed up the girl, you're an asshole.
Really?
That's what I was, an asshole, because I play hard at everything. I don't care who's defending me, and I'm pretty bad at basketball. So
I know a gang of females who are amazing hoopers.
Look,
and I wouldn't even get in front of them because they're beasts.
Speaking of, because we didn't do the story, we probably should have. Have you seen UConn's women's program win 100 straight games?
Yeah, bro.
That's good.
That's phenomenal.
It's good.
Yeah, the stories like this that come around that I love. There was one not long ago that was.
Who's gonna D up the kid with no arms?
There was a kid.
Apparently, Jason would.
I would never.
Jason would.
No, I'd swat him though. If he went in for like a layup or tried something, just.
If he tried dunk on you, would you?
Hey guys, I would. You know why? Because I'm terrible at basketball. Anything for me to get the breaks.
100% on D.
I'm a bad man.
Really? You guys are all horrible.
What would you do?
I wouldn't let him shoot. I don't think that. I think that he's better than me, undoubtedly. But there was a kid that came around. It was I believe. Playing soccer, right, and using crutches as a means to play, and he was phenomenal. Like, I think he had one leg.
I think
he was very, very good. And they were trying to defend him, but he was still very. I mean, it's just remarkable how people who are able to overcome such adversity can train their body in a way so that it doesn't hinder them in some of these life experiences. And I just give. It's just so courageous, and it's a testament to that kind of attitude that takes them through.
You know
it's
what?
Great to see.
I would D him up, Jacory, and here's the reason why. I can't speak out of any form of empathy because I have my limbs. I don't know what this kid has gone through. Obviously.
Why are you rubbing it in his face, Jason?
What's up?
Why are you rubbing it in his face?
And my point being, though, is I would D up the kid because I don't think he wants to be treated any differently. He wants to be treated as an opponent on the basketball court. And look, those shots were soaking wet.
Yeah.
I mean, it wasn't like. That there was like nobody on the floor, but look, D him up.
I agree with that.
And if you get beat with the guy with no arm, geez, man, you're gonna be.
I just think there's
gonna be on a poster.
I can't speak on behalf, but I've spoke to a lot of people who, in the past, from playing football and speaking to kids that couldn't perform. Maybe they had one leg, or they went through a period where they couldn't use both, and when they're training to try and get back to a state where they can perform, they don't want to feel like they're lesser. And they want to be able to feel like they can
be better.
Yeah, to be treated equally. Because I can't speak on behalf, but what I try to understand is that I don't imagine it feels good if they feel like it's not just. Or like I made that shot, but no one was there to try and guard me. I think there'll be a level of respect if you played to the same level.
I feel you to an extent, but like in high school at that level, like that kid's got family coming to see him, and like extended family. Like grandma flew in from Wisconsin.
Have you seen what of the high school ballers can do?
Hey man, you put the camera right back on me, baby. Listen, we had females on our football team in high school, and we didn't treat them any different. We went hard on them, and they went hard on us.
How hard did you get hit by a female?
Yo, there was some females on our team that were like balling out.
And I went through the same thing. I had, so like we did wrestling, and because if there's no female team, the females are allowed to compete with the boys. Yes. So the females were allowed to compete with us, and we had girls on our team, and we competed against girls. And of course, we beat the shit out of the girls that were on our team because they were our teammates. We knew what they were capable of. We knew they would want to be held to any different standard. But when you're going up against a different person that you've never gone against before, and you don't, like you said, you look up and you see grandma in the crowd cheering them on and stuff. It's hard.
You're body slamming girls in front of grandma. That's
dude,
so
I would talk. No, it's hard. If I'm that kid, I would just start. I would learn from the best trash talkers in the NBA and just start mentally getting inside their heads.
Yes.
Look, you can talk trash as much as you want. Just make it creative, and that kid could just. You imagine what this kid can come up with?
Honey Nut Cheerios.
Honey Nut.
Can you blow us up one more time before we get out of here? No? Okay. I can't blow us up. Damn. Wow. What was that?
Whoa.
That was the wrong blow up.
You guys said you wanted to get blown up.
I'm a morning farter.
Are you a morning farter?
I'm not afternoon.
I'm a morning farter too.
The first couple cups
I'm a
of
late
coffee.
Night. I'm a late night, like, cuddle under the blankets farter. My lady hates that. Oh! Wow. I'm never coming back.
You have the best sound effects. Oh!
One more.
One more. He's like, one more.
One more.
One more, please. Another one.
Another.